Good morning, students. Today in this lecture, we will discuss about the Zener diodes and some numericals on Zener diode, and we will see how Zener diode work as a voltage regulators. So first of all, before starting the Zener diode, we will briefly revise the pricing of our junction diode. Yeah, what about the ordinary diode? So when we are talking about the ordinary diode, that is basically a combination of p-type and n-type semiconductor materials. So we have to call, when we want to work on a diode or when we want to use diode as a different applications, so according to biasing, we will see that when how we can run the forward biasing of a diode and how we can run the reverse biasing. So as we have to already seen that when p terminal of diode is connected to positive and n terminal is connected to the negative of battery, that is called as a forward biasing. And when n terminal of diode is connected to the positive and p terminal is connected to the negative terminal of battery, that is called as reverse biasing diode. So before starting our junction, we can see what here we have to say, that how we can run the forward bias. So when we have done the forward bias, our diode will conduct and depletion layer width will be reduces. And when we done the reverse biasing of our diode, the depletion layer width will be increases. So basically, this is the VI characteristics. Okay, what will happen when we turn the forward biasing of a diode? So according to that, at initially, when we increase our forward bias voltage VF, that is called as a forward bias voltage. So at initial, some amount of biasing voltage is consumed to removing the depletion layers. And after then, when your depletion layer width will be reduces, then your current will be rises suddenly. So that is the particular point where we can achieve the large amount of current. So that is called as a cut-in voltage. Same thing is here in the when we are working on the reverse biasing mode. So there is a very small amount of current will flow, and that very small of current is due to the minority carriers, because for minority carriers, reverse biases work as a forward bias. So that is the reason initially very small amount of current, approximate microamperes current, will flow through the diode, and after then there may be a breakdown and sudden large amount of current will flow the reverse bias mode. So that is a very basic descriptions of our PN diode, how our PN diode is work. Now we will say about the Zener diode. So Zener diode behaves just like a normal general purpose diode consisting of a silicon PN junction. So that is, Zener diode is just like a general purpose diode. So when it is biased in forward diode, the anode positive with respect to cathode, it behaves just like a normal diode, as I have already seen in our previous slides. This is because when when it is reverse biased, so reverse voltage applied across the Zener diode exceeds the rated voltage of the device, a process called as a avalanche breakdown occurs in the semiconductor depletion layer, and current starts to flow through the diode to limit this increase in voltage. So that is basically when we are there is a reverse bias applied across the Zener diode, after particular voltage the amount of current will exceed, and due to this current starts to flow through the diode, so it will limit the increase in voltage, and that particular point we will achieve constant voltage in the reverse bias mode of Zener voltage, Zener diode. So now current flowing through the Zener diode increases dramatically to the maximum circuit value, which is usually limited by a series resistor, and once achieved, this reverse saturation currents remains fairly constant over a wide range of the reverse voltage. So voltage, particular voltage point at which voltage across the Zener diode becomes stable, it is called as a Zener diode. And for Zener diode, this voltage can range from less than 1 volt to few hundred volt. The point at which Zener voltage triggers the current to flow through the diode can be very accurately controlled in the doping stage of the diode semiconductor. So construction giving the diode a specific Zener breakdown voltage VZ, for example 4.3 volt or 7.5 volt, and this Zener breakdown voltage on the IV curve is almost vertical straight line. So as you have to see in our diagram, so this is basically a vertical straight line, and this is the maximum current which will flow through the reverse bias mode. And we will see that at that particular all values of that current, our the voltage is constant all the time. So that is the constant Zener voltage is provided by that the Zener diode. And this is the forward characteristics, and that is the very similar to the ordinary diode. If we are talking about the symbols, where that this is the symbol of our Zener diode, and the anode plate is just like a Z shape. So you can see just the basic symbol of our Zener diode. And the voltage of will be maintained constant. So this voltage remains almost constant even with large changes in current providing the Zener diode current remains between the breakdown current and its maximum current rating. So this ability of Zener diode to control itself can be used to great effect to regulate or stabilize a voltage source against supply or load variations. So if you are changes any type of input voltage, or you are changing any type of load variations are there, but Zener diode will always give the constant voltage across the Zener diode. So this is the ability of Zener diode to control itself to the variations in any type of input variations or load variations. So the fact that voltage across the diode in the breakdown region is almost constant turns out to be an important characteristics of Zener diode, as it can be used in the simplest type of voltage regulator applications. So basically it will be used in the voltage regulators. The function of voltage regulator is to provide a constant output voltage to a load connected in parallel with it in spite of the ripples in the supply voltage or variations in the load current. So basically if you are talking about the voltage regulator, so the function of voltage regulator, it will always provide the constant output voltage to the load, and it will connect it to the parallel with the load. A Zener diode will continue to regulate its voltage until diode's holding current fall off below the minimum value in the reverse breakdown region. So it will provide the constant. Just we will see how it will work as a regulator. So Zener diode can be used to produce a stabilized voltage output with low ripple under the varying load current conditions. So by passing a small current through the diode from voltage source via a suitable current limiting resistor RS, this Zener diode will conduct sufficient current to maintain a voltage drop of the V output. So we can see here by there is a limiting resistor RS, and Zener diode will conduct sufficient current to maintain a voltage drop of the V output. So you can see here, this is a Zener diode, and in front of in parallel with the Zener diode there is a load resistance RL, and it is a series resistance RL to limit the value of current. And this is the DC input voltage from rectifier or smoothing circuit, and we will provide it for voltage regulator purpose. So we can see here this current IS, that is a signal current or input current, that is divided into the two part, IL load current and the IZ Zener current. So that is basically 0 to plus V. And this is a VIN or VS, and that is a V output, that is a VZ, RL. So RL is the variable resistance or load resistance. So you can vary your load resistance, but you can always achieve the constant voltage across that particular load. So this is the voltage stabilization of the Zener diode. So by using this circuit, we can solve the numericals on that particular key, how in spite of changing the input voltage or in spite of changing the load regulation, load voltage, load resistance, how we can achieve the constant voltage across the load. So there is a resistor RS is connected in series with the Zener diode to limit the current flow through the diode, with the voltage source VS being connected across the combinations. So the stabilized output voltage V out is taken from across the Zener diode. So now we will start from the some numericals, how we can achieve the voltage across the Zener constant voltage. So in this diagram, first of all, the output voltage drop across the series resistance, and you have to calculate the current through the Zener diode. So now we will start from the, you have to given the 120 volt input supply, and we have to given the Zener diode of 50 volt rating. And there is a load resistance RL, that is the 10 kilo ohm. And there is a series resistance R, that is equal to 5 kilo. So now we will, let's start from the here. Now what about the voltage V? So you have to given the voltage V across the open circuit. If you remove the Zener diode, so what amount of voltage drop there? So suppose that since there is a load resistance RL, so we have to calculate the voltage drop across the RL. And if input voltage is EI and total resistance, that is equal to R plus RL. So we have to calculate the voltage drop across the resistance RL V, that is equal to 80 volt. Since voltage across Zener diode is greater than 50 volt, Zener is in the on state. So if we apply the Zener diode, so what will happen here? It will be the voltage of 50 volt. So it will be the on state because it is receiving the voltage of the 80 volt across there. So output voltage VZ, that is always the 50 volt, because voltage across the Zener diode, that will be the constant. Now we will see that voltage drop across the R. So R is the, so what about the, what will happen in that particular loop? You can see in this diagram. Yeah. You have to apply a 120 volt, you have to calculate the voltage drop across R, and this is a voltage of 50 volt. So first of all, you have to calculate the current I, what amount of current I are flowing through this loop. So first of all, we will calculate the current I, and that is a basically 70 volt is divided by the total resistance. So we can calculate the value of I, so that is equal to 14 milliampere. And what about the voltage VZ, that is a 50 volt, and what about the resistance of our load resistance? So load current IL, that is equal to the 50 volt upon 10 kilo ohm. So that is the 5 milliampere. So IZ, so first of all, total current I, which is flowing due to the input resistance, input voltage, that is equal to 14 milliampere. You can calculate it because input voltage is minus VZ, that is equal to 70 volt is drop across the R. So if you have to given the 70 volt drop, and if you have to given the value of resistance, then you can easily calculate the total current I, that is equal to the 14 milliampere. So I is equal to IL plus IZ. You can find out the I, you have to find out the IL. So by using these two values, we can find out the IZ, and that is equal to 9 milliampere. So that is a different values. By using that particular problems, we can calculate it. So I think you have given the, so when you have to find out 120 minus 50 volts, so you can calculate the value of I, 14 milliampere, then you can calculate the drop across the I. Since what about the load current IL? You know, since drop across the Zener diode, that is 50 volts, so drop across load resistance would also be 50 volt because both are in parallel. So 50 volt divided by 10, you can find out the 5 milliampere current here. 14 milliampere is total current. So remaining amount of current will be the Zener current. So by using this circuit diagram, we can easily calculate the value. Now this is again another question. For the circuit shown in figure, first find the maximum and minimum value of the Zener diode current. So now we will see here. This is the circuit diagram, the variation of the input voltage, that is the 80 volt to 120 volt. Zener diode is connected across this, and that is a 50 volt Zener diode and 10 kilo ohm load resistance. So first of all, first step is to determine the state of Zener diode. It is easy to see that given range of 80 to 120 volt, voltage across the Zener is greater than the 50 volt. Hence, the Zener diode will be in the on state for this range of applied voltages. So consequently, it can be replaced by a battery of 50 volt. So you can see here 120 volt minus 50 volt. So that is again the 70 volt, and that 70 volt divided by this one. So that is the basically amount of current. So first of all, when you have to take the 120 volt, this part is the same. Now we have to change the supply voltage. Now you have to minimum zener current. So means applied voltage is basically 80 volt. So there are two conditions, maximum zener current or minimum zener current. So zener will conduct the minimum current when input voltage value is the minimum. So there is a minimum value of input voltage, that is the 80 volt. So we will apply this 80 volt, and now according to 80 volt input supply, we will calculate the voltage across the 5 kilo ohm, and that will be the, we can calculate the current through it. Now load current IL, that is equal to 5 milliampere. So zener, so you can calculate the zener current IZ. So that is equal to 1 milliampere. Now there is a third question. 7.2 volt zener is used in the circuit shown in figure, and load current is say vary from 12 to 100 milliampere. So there is a change in load current value, and find the value of series resistance R to maintain a voltage of 7.2 volt across the load. So input voltage is constant at 12 volt and minimum zener current is given to you is 10 milliampere. So you can see here the input supply voltage, what we have to apply is 12 volt. Minimum zener current you have to given, that is the 10 milliampere. And you have to also given the load current, that will vary from 1200 milliampere. So first of all, you have to calculate the series resistance. So voltage across R is to remain constant at 12 minus 7.2, that is 4.8 volt. As the load current changes from 12 to 100 milliampere, the minimum zener current will also occur when load current is maximum. So you can see EI minus E0. So that is the 7.2 volt. VZ is the equal to 7.2 volt. So by using the particular, when IZ is minimum, IL is the maximum value. So you can calculate from here value of R. So what type of series resistance is applied here? Now if R is equal to 43.5 is inserted in the circuit, output voltage will remain constant over the regulating range. As load current decreases, the zener current will increase to such a value that IZ plus IL, that is equal to 110 milliampere. So note that if load resistance is open circuited, then IL is equal to 0 and zener current becomes the 110 milliampere. So when load current is 0, zener current is 110 milliampere. Now we will see the next question. You can see in this diagram, you have to given the zener diode, VZ, that is equal to 18 volt, voltage across the load, that is also 18 volt because both are connected in parallel. IZ is maintained between the 200 milliampere and 2 ampere. Find the value of series resistance R so that E0 remains 18 volt while input voltage EI is free to vary between 22 volt to 28 volt. So while input voltage, so you can see input voltage is vary between 22 volt to 28 volt. VZ given to you 18 volt. Load IZ is maintained between the 200 milliampere and 2 ampere. So you have to find the series resistance R. Zener current will be minimum when the input voltage is minimum and load current stays at constant value, that is 1000 milliampere. You can see here EI minus E0. then you can calculate the value of R. A 10 volt Zener diode is used to regulate the voltage across a variable load resistor. The input voltage varies between 13 volt and 16 volt, and load current varies between the 10 milliampere and 85 milliampere. The minimum Zener current is 15 milliampere. Calculate the value of series resistance R. So first of all, you have to give the input voltage, that is the 13 volt to 16 volt. And load current varies between the 10 milliampere and 85 milliampere. So that is also the range, and minimum Zener current is the 15 milliampere. So how you can calculate the resistance value? So first of all, Zener will conduct the minimum current when input voltage is minimum. So you have to apply the EI, that is the 13 volt. You can see here, that is the minimum voltage applied. And minimum Zener current will be 50 milliampere, and load current will be the maximum. When Zener current will be the minimum, load current IL will be the maximum value. So from here we can calculate the this one. You will select the load current 85 milliampere from here. Now here is this question number 6. The circuit of figure uses two Zener diode, each rated at 15 volt 200 milliampere. If circuit is connected to a 45 volt unregulated supply, determine the regulated output voltage and value of series resistance R. So here we will see that here is the series resistance, input Zener diode, each rated at a 15 volt 200 milliampere. So 45 volt unregulated supply, we have to connect it the unregulated power supply, regulated output voltage and value of series resistance R, Z1 and Z2, RI is the low output resistance. You have to connect it the two Zener diode. So what will happen here? When the desired regulated output voltage is higher than the rated voltage of Zener, two or more Zeners are connected in series. So however, in such circuits, care must be taken to select those Zeners that have the same current rating. So if we are using the two Zener diode, so regulated output voltage will be the addition of both the diodes, Z1 and Z2. So we are working on the both the diodes are 15 volt rating. So that is the 30 volt regulated output voltage we can use. Input voltage, that is equal to the 45 volts, and voltage rating is each of the 15 volts. So as you have already seen, and current rating of each Zener diode, that is the 200 milliampere. So according to that, when you have to calculate the series resistance, so EI minus E0, so E0 equal to 13. So that is equal to IZ. And by using this formula, you can calculate the series resistance. So that is the series resistance R, regulated output voltage, now next question will, what value of series resistance is required when 3, 10 watt, 10 volt and 100 milliampere Zener diodes are connected in series to obtain a 30 volt regulated output from a 45 volt DC power source. So you can see what value of series resistance is required when 3, 10 watt, 10 volt, 100 milliampere Zener diode. So you have to know that you have to require the 30 volt regulated output voltage, and from you have to require from the 45 volt DC power source. So the worst case is at no load, because when zener carry the maximum current. So suppose there is a no load voltage, and output across that load is that is equal to the 30 volt. So we can see here voltage rating. We have to 10, 10, 10, and we have to connect it all three zener diode in series. So that is equal to 30 volt. R be the required series resistance. So that will be also here. And little bit input unregulated voltage. So that is the input voltage that is equal to 45 volt. And now voltage across the R, EI minus E0, and that is divided by the IZ. And IZ is the current rating of the zener diode. So that will be the 1000 milliampere. So according to that, we will calculate the value of R. That is equal to 15 ohm. So we have to require that if we are connecting the zener diode in a series, so value of that particular greater than the 30 volt across. So over what range of input voltage will the zener circuit shown maintain 30 volt across 2000 ohm load, assuming that series resistance and zener current rating is 25 milliampere. So you have to given the load resistance 2000 ohm and series resistance R that is equal to 200 ohm, and the zener current rating is the 25 milliampere. The minimum input voltage required will be when IZ equal to 0. So what is the conditions? Minimum input voltage required when IZ barabar 0, and under this condition load current IL that is equal to I. And in this conditions we can calculate the 15 milliampere, because you have to given the parameters of, you can see here, you have to calculate the IL. Minimum input voltage that is equal to 30 plus I into R. So 30 volt is the voltage across the zener diode. You can see here. 30 volt is the load resistance, and you have to calculate the drop across R, and that will be equivalent to EI. So that is I is equal to 15 milliampere and R is equal to 200 ohm as we have to. Given. So what about the minimum input voltage that is equal to 30 plus 3, 33 volt. So maximum input voltage required will be IZ 25 milliampere, and under these conditions you can see here. IL plus IZ, so that is the made up of I. So IZ is 25 milliampere, so according to that we can calculate the 40. So maximum input voltage that is equal to 30 plus I into R, so that is equal to 38 voltage. So therefore input voltage range over which circuit will maintain 30 volt load across 30 volt across the load is 33 volt to 38 volt. Now in the circuit shown in figure, voltage across the load is maintained at 12 volt. So suppose 12 volt is maintained across the load, and the load current varies from 0 to 200 milliampere. So design the regulator. Also find the maximum voltage rating of zener diode. So you have to given the 16 volt input supply, as we have to seen in this diagram. And there is a variable load is connected. So by designing the regulator, here we means to find the value of VZ and R. Since load voltage is to be maintained at 12 volt, so we will use a zener diode of 12 volt. So this is also according to load voltage is to be maintained 12 volt. So we can also use the zener diode of 12 volt because both are connected in the parallel path. So just see here, value of VZNR since load current is to be maintained at the 12 volt. So voltage across R is to remain constant and you have to given the 12 volt and input supply voltage is 16. So 4 volt as the load current changes from 0 to 200 milliampere. So minimum zener current will occur when load current is maximum. So you can see here you have to calculate EI minus E0, IZ min and IN max. So minimum zener current that will be equal to 0. So there will be the maximum load current 200 milliampere. And according to that we will find out the value of R that is equal to 20. Now maximum power rating of zener is that is P VZ upon IZN. Now in question number 10, figure 10 shows the basic zener diode circuits. What will be the circuit behavior if zener is working properly shorted and open circuited? So according to that, we will draw a three diagrams. Zener is working, shorted and open circuit conditions. So if zener diode is working properly, so voltage across the load will be nearly 6 volt. If zener diode is short circuited, so you will measure the V0 as 0 volt. So the same problem could also be caused by the short circuit load resistance or open source resistor. So the only way to tell which device has failed is to remove the resistors and check them with an ohmmeter. If zener diode is open circuited, voltage V0 across the load will be 10 volt. Now this question is regulated power supply using a zener diode. So here we will working on the bridges. So when you can also see the circuit. It is just a theoretical question and we have to explain what will happen. So we will move to the another example. So we have to also given the zener diode. Now we will little bit, as I have to also told you, we will also discuss about the some numericals on semiconductor materials. So we will see that what about the different charges which is available. So calculate the total number of energy state per unit volume in silicon between the lowest level in the conduction band and the level KT above this level at T is equal to 300 Kelvin. So we have to calculate the effective mass of the electron in the conduction band is 1.08 times that of a free electron. So that is equal to 8 pi m e, that is 3 by 2 e minus e c. So according to that formula, what about the energy level between this and this, that is given to you and you can calculate by using the different values. Now we will again switch to the intrinsic gallium arsenide, the electron and hole mobility. You have to given the mobility of electron and hole. And effective masses of electron and hole respectively are, you have to also given the mass of that particular. The energy band gap is 1.43 electron. Determine the carrier density and conductivity at 3 degree, 300 Kelvin. So what will happen here? You have to calculate the conductivity of semiconductor materials. And that is a basically Ne, mu e plus mu p. So mu e is the mobility of electrons and mobility of the charge carriers. So you have to given the electron and hole mobility 0.85 into the 0.04. According to that, we have to put these values and we can find out the conductivity of the semiconductor material. Now there is a numericals on semiconductor. So a sample of silicon at room temperature, you have to given intrinsic resistivity of, you have to given the intrinsic resistivity. The sample is doped with 4 into 10 to the power 18 donor atoms per meter cube and the 16 acceptor atoms. So find the total current density if electric field of 400 volt per meter is applied across the sample. You have to given the electron mobility. So you can calculate the conductivity. So from charge neutrality equations, Nd plus p that is equal to n, and n and p that is equal to ni square. So according to that formula, we can calculate the value of p. Now we will again see the one or two numericals on this. So since the minority carrier concentration, PNN, conductivity, you can calculate the conductivity of that particular, and J is equal to sigma E. So that is basically calculating the density of that particular sequence. Now there is again in numericals on semiconductor materials, there is a pure germanium has intrinsic charge carrier density 300 Kelvin and it is doped with a donor impurities of 1 in every 10 to the power 6 germanium atoms. What is the resistivity of the doped germanium? Electron mobility and hole mobility are, you have to given the both of the mobility factors. GE atom density is 4.2 into 10 to the power 28, and if this germanium bar is 5 mm long in cross-sectional area, so what is its resistance? So first of all, you have to calculate the number of doped carriers, so that is equal to the Nd. So you have to given the density. By using this formula, we can calculate it. Since all the atoms are ionized, so total electron density in germanium, that is equal to this Nd plus. So from law of mass action, we can calculate the value of NH. So number of holes in particular by using this formula. And after then, we will calculate the electrical conductivity sigma. So you have to given the concentration and mobility of devices. So now you can see here how you can calculate this one from law of mass action. So here basically you have to revise the basic formulas of what about the mobility of holes and electrons, what is the basic charge of at that particular electrons. So that is basically number of atoms, Nd plus NH, holes and something. So you can also calculate by using this formula. There is again a numericals on semiconductor. So resistance of the germanium bar, you have to give a voltage drop across the germanium bar, that is equal to V is equal to I into R. So according to that, we can solve these questions. So we can see here in this lecture, we will discuss about the some numericals problem also. And that numerical problem is based on the Zener diode. So mostly we have to study about the Zener diode, how Zener diode work as a voltage regulators. So according to that, we have to design a Zener diode. So there are many parameters. We have a series resistance, we have a load resistance, we have an input supply voltage. So there is a certain range of input supply voltage. And according to that, there is this change in the load current. So we can see that when we are applying the Zener diode, a constant voltage we will receive across the output, and whatever changes in input you have to done in your input supply voltage, and what type of changes you have to done at the load current values. So according to that particular point, we can, in spite of changes in these both the parameters, we can achieve the constant voltage across the Zener diode. So this is a basic applications. So by using these applications, we have to design a voltage regulators by using the Zener diode, and we have to also say in so many numericals ki you can if you want to increase the constant voltage or regulated voltage supply across the Zener increasing, so you have to connect the Zener diode in a series combination, and by using such type of combinations we can enhance the regulated power supply of our Zener diode. So now there is some objective questions based on the Zener diode. So we will see here. Zener diodes are basically used for, so you can write voltage regulator, forward bias diode, breakdown diode, none of. So that is basically in which applications we are working on the Zener diode. Which of the following is true about the resistance of a Zener diode? So what type of resistance, internal resistance of our Zener diode? So it has an incremental resistance, it has dynamic resistance. The value of resistance is the inverse of the slope of IV characteristics of Zener diode and all of the mentioned. So according to that we will define. Which of the following is true about the temperature coefficient TC of the Zener diode? So for Zener voltage less than 5 volt TC is negative, and for Zener voltage around 5 volt TC can be made zero. So that is a basically temperature coefficient. So what about the temperature coefficients of our Zener diode? And for higher value of temperature coefficient is positive or all of the above. So we have to know about this very precisely. And which of the following can be used in the series with Zener diode so that combinations has almost zero temperature coefficient? So what type of devices, either you have to add the diode, resistor, transistor or MOSFETs. So you have no, we have to add a series limiting resistance. So in Zener diode, for current greater than the knee current, the VI curve is almost. So what about the shape of VI curve? Almost a straight line parallel to Y axis. Almost a straight line parallel to x-axis, equally inclined to both the axis with a positive slope, equally inclined to both the axis with a negative slope. So you have to know what type of changes we are doing here. So that is basically Zener diode can be effectively used in the voltage regulator. So the main applications of our Zener diode is it is used in the voltage regulator. So we can see here these Zener diodes can be used in our, so that is the operational amplifier, MOSFET, integrated circuit and none of above. So what type of implementation we have to do in Zener diode? Now you have to, again there is a numerical, so you have to given the 9.1 volt Zener diode exhibits its nominal voltage at a test current of 28 milliampere. At this current, the incremental resistance is specified at 5 volt. So you have to, at this current, the incremental resistance is 5 ohm. Find out of Zener model. So you can know the Zener model of before see how it can work. So according to that particular model you can find out the values. Shunt regulator utilizing a Zener diode with an incremental resistance of 5 ohm is fed through an 82 ohm resistor. If the raw supply changes by 1.0 volt, what is the corresponding change in the regulated output voltage? So you have to given the shunt regulator using a Zener diode with an incremental resistance of 5 ohm is fed through a 82 ohm resistor. So if the raw supply changes by 1 volt, what is the corresponding change in the regulated output voltage? In a Zener diode with high breakdown voltage, both P and N are highly doped and both P and N are lightly doped. So if we have to know okay, what type of construction features we are using in Zener diode. So in Zener diode, for high breakdown voltage, we have to highly doped. So that is the basic characteristics of that. So I think it will be sufficient for Zener diode, why we are working Zener diode as a voltage regulator. So the basic applications, if you are changing your input voltage, your Zener current values will be changed, but voltage across that particular value would be constant. If you are changing your the load resistances, there is nothing effect on the voltage on the Zener diode, and it will always maintain a constant value across that particular diode. So this is a very important characteristics of Zener diode, where we have to apply the constant voltage all time across that. So that for particular applications, we have to use our Zener diode. So that will be the complete of Zener diode. So now, okay, thank you.